16 months in charge of the Super Eagles. At least 10 players have made their international debut for Nigeria. But like Oliver Twist, coach Garnet Rowe is still searching for more ahead of the 2018 FIFA World Cup. And away from football, the Athletics Federation of Nigeria holds its congress in Abuja as they look to focus on grassroots. This is Bounce Sports, and I am Israel Ojoko.
The only team we want to Eagles going to be avoid is only one. Is the only one, one team, one country. That's the host country. I mean Morocco.
Okay.
The other team we are going to they're going to be easy for. Yeah, it was a great experience for me playing along with player like Mikel Obi, Victor Moses, because I only saw them on the TV. I've not seen them face to face before. So because he played again, he played along with my brother. At the Meridian Cup 2013. When I saw the picture and I said to my mother, I would like to play along with Mikel Obi. I tell God my dream came true. Yeah, I would say nothing is possible. Nothing is impossible. Nothing, because we don't know what will happen tomorrow. Like the last World Cup now. I think it's only one, I've been one or two hombres that they pick along to the World Cup. Player like Odulami, but I didn't know maybe it's 2-1. Like Odulami, and I don't know anything can happen. I don't know what Garnet Rowe is planning for the home base player. I don't know what will happen.
Welcome back. As usual, my co-colleague is here, Batunde Eludini, but let's leave him aside. I have a colleague too, a very reliable colleague, Charles Diya from the New Telegraph newspaper. Charles Diya, you're welcome to the show today.
It's true. It's nice to be here. It's first time to be on the show.
I hope you enjoy this too.
Yeah. Especially the antics of Tunde.
All right. So looking at the Chan, Equatorial Guinea, Libya, and of course Rwanda, our group opponents. Tunde, let me throw this to you. I mean, when the draw was held, what came to your mind?
I think it's a tricky draw. You look at the teams there on the surface. If you don't follow African football, you can easily say Libya, Rwanda, Guinea-Bissau. Erroneously think that they are easy teams. But when you look at the leagues in these countries, of course, you know the chance is for players based in their countries. Then you should have a second thought. Rwanda, for example, they have a good growing league. We could remember what the team from Rwanda did in the CAF competition against Rivers United. We saw what they brought to the table. Also for Libya, we're very aware that even teams from players from across Africa go to Libya to play their league football. So it shows that they have a very respectable league there. And come to think of it, Libya has actually won the CHAN tournament before. So they are former champions, if you want to put it that way. So Nigeria has their work cut out. They have to be careful. They have to take each game as it comes and be very prepared for this.
But Ramon, Afiz Aremu said it's only Morocco he or Nigeria should be scared of, and not any of these teams that you just mentioned.
For me, I think that would be suicidal if he feels that just Morocco. Of course, we heard him say just Morocco, but for me, it's going to be suicidal to think only Morocco is the big fish to fear. Like I said, Libya, they are former champions, and they have what it takes. They have even their national team. Most of their players play in the local league, so you won't be surprised to see players have been playing the World Cup qualifiers coming to play CHAN. So it shows that they already have some chemistry going on into before this tournament. So Nigeria has to be careful. If there is one team I think is going to be a soft spot for Nigeria, and that you can't even rule out, that's going to be Equatorial Guinea. But like I said, this is African football. It's a different ball game. So the Super Eagles have to be very careful if they really want to make the best from this tournament.
Charles, now we know the opponents. there is need for preparation and all that. What do you think this team has?
Yeah, Israel, Tony was saying the other time, some of these teams that we're talking about, Libya, Real Sport of Rwanda came to Nigeria and they hosted the last championship, if you remember. I was in Rwanda for the championship last year, and we can see what Rwanda did at the competition. And they came from back the backyard to qualify. You know, they were not supposed to be. It was because a country pulled out, yeah, and that's why they were coming in to the competition. But seriously, they have bulk of their players playing in the in the league. They play with APR, Rayon Sport, and maybe one or two, some of the other clubs in the country. And they have a solid league going for them in their country. We should not forget what really happened to Nigeria at the last championship. We were topping our group, and we believe that, oh, we just need to beat Guinea or just pick a point against Guinea. And this same thing came around to beat up. I remember one of the players shouting there that, Nigeria, we beat Nigeria. Wow. He was so happy that for them to come to beat Nigeria and qualify ahead of Nigeria. Salisu was telling me just at the weekend that he doesn't even know this team, that you need to research about them, you need to watch their clips, you need to see how they qualify for this competition, you need to know what they've been doing in the past so that you can prepare for the championship. It's said one thing that I really, you know, they went for a competition, Wafu Cup, to prepare for the champ. He said, but unluckily for them, none of the team that play at the Wafu competition will be in their group. So they have to start all over again and look at the opponent. But seriously, they need to do something. If we really want to show the world that Nigeria League is a good league, then these boys must do something and get past the position they got to in the past. That is third place position.
Tunde, away from Chan 2018, World Cup 2018 is coming again. And of course, Gareth Rowe is still searching an Oliver Twist. At least 10 players have made their debut under his watch as a coach since he took over 15 months ago. But Gareth Rowe is still searching. What is he looking for?
I think he has to continue searching until
until he can search no more.
He has to transfer the length and breadth of the world. From what you said, he has been to Germany. I think we still expect him to go to Dubai.
He won't go to Dubai. Seriously, I can bet you that.
I know. You will have to go to countries that have rich playing football history. His trip to Germany, for me, I think is a welcome development. But one thing that
he's a German. He actually went there to rest.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then to watch some Nigerians play.
If you look at it, the Nigerian team for me is, like I said in our previous edition, it's still a work in progress. And any player that will bring a quality addition to the team is welcome. The only thing I would not subscribe to is going all out to beg players to come and play for Nigeria. For any player that feels that he wants to pick up the chance of going to the World Cup with Nigeria, should readily come out and say, okay, this is how good I am. Give me a chance. Let me prove myself to you. But in a sense that would now go frustrating and begging players to come and play for Nigeria, I think that won't be too good for our image. Of course, we need these players, and these players need it also. It's every player's dream to play at the World Cup. And for players like the Kelvin Pogba that is being, though he's quite young, if he doesn't go to this World Cup, maybe he'll be targeting Qatar 2022. So it's a win-win situation for us. If they are good enough, let them come on board. That's just it.
Charles, barely 7 months to the World Cup, and Nigeria is still looking for players that will represent the country at the World Cup. Does this make sense at this point?
No. I won't subscribe to that. We are still looking for players to represent at the World Cup. I can bet you categorically that we have.
But
like,
I mean, who made his debut?
We have like 11 players already that have already secured their spot.
Starting 11.
No, not starting 11, but at least 11 players have secured their spot at the World Cup. At least I have I know of Idowu has secured the spot.
After one game?
No, it's not about playing one game. Like the coach said, he said he's going to be their official interpreter in Russia. He plays there, he was born there, so he will be of added advantage to the team. So and he has shown that he can even play. That's just it.
And he can score too.
He nearly scored two goals. This goal that got us the equalizer to make the game 2-2 by Iwobi. He would have scored the goal if Iwobi didn't play the ball. If he didn't score the ball, because he was there. The point is, one thing about the guy, he has right position. Yeah. He was there at the right spot at the right time. So he's going to be a good addition to the player. Then we're looking at, you know, when we play against South Africa, there was a difficulty in replacing the two, Balogun and Chusekong. Balogun was not there, and Ekong was nowhere to be found. It's only when Balogun came back. So the coach is looking for, that's why he's looking at Kelvin.
Central defense.
Kelvin can play all the position at the back four. So that's why he's looking at. And what this guy said, he said he's not looking at this World Cup alone. He's looking at a player, team, you know, set of players that would be at the World Cup, that will be playing for the Super Eagle for the next at least 10 years. And that's what this man did there. Westhoff did during his time. He gave us a team, players that can play for a team that can play for almost 10 years, for more than 10 years. The same team that played at 92 Nations Cup, played at 94, was the same team that played 96 at Atlanta Olympic, bulk of the players. So I think we are on the right path. Some of these guys might not play, but at least they are for the future.
All right, Bounce Sport will be back after now.
We've already at the concluding level now. At the Congress that we are calling soon, we will be presenting and unveiling a new logo by the Honorable Minister for Sports. We would do that at the Congress, where, again, a ratification of the Constitution, the very first ever Constitution of the Athletics Federation of Nigeria, will be ratified.
So what are you looking forward to in the logo? What are we looking forward to?
It should be a surprise, and I think you'll be happy to have a new logo that will be an up-to-date and world standard, will be in comparison with what is obtainable in the world at IAAF, CAA, and the world federations. I can tell you basics. When I say basics, I mean grassroots. We need to go back. We lost it midway, so we need to go back and start. While we are maintaining our elite athletes, we also do a lot of work at the grassroots, so that in the next 2, 3, 4 years, you will see a brand new set of athletes coming out of Nigeria.
Welcome back. Charles, I know you cover athletics, and we just listened to Athletics Federation of Nigeria President Ibrahim Gusau saying there will be focus on grassroots in athletics. You were at the Congress just held. What transpired?
Oh, the Congress was a successful one, and so many things. At least they have the new logo, the new AFN logo after 44 years, and they were talking about building.
What did you see in the logo? What are the differences? What the different?
Well, this new logo depicts athletics itself. The technical director Sunday Adeleye was actually explaining the colors. The tape has to do with when you finish your race. Then the gold for the gold medal, and the green. I think the green is for the country.
Doesn't make sense to you?
Well, at least it shows somebody running. Compared to the crest that we have in the past, that doesn't. If they remove the AFN from the crest in the past, you can't even know what's the head. But that one, if they remove the AFN, at least you know that this thing has to do with sports, athletics. Somebody is running. It might be a footballer that is running, but at least you know that it has to do with sports and
back
athletics.
To the high points of the Congress.
Yeah, like they were saying, they actually wanted to go back to the grassroots. They're planning to unearth talents. That different localities, they are trying to bring them up and have a semblance of Nigerians competing. During the Congress, the minister was like, Nigeria was supposed to be a leading light for other African countries. I was surprised that most of these athletes competing for other countries. By the time this one is from this country, most of them are from Africa. Like Nigeria, about 12 or thereabouts in Bahrain competing. For the country, and they are all from Nigeria. But seriously, if we can have, because we have Commonwealth Games in April, so they have to do so many things to be able to prepare to have athletes that will go to the Commonwealth Games and do the country proud. We should not forget what we did at the last Commonwealth Games. We need to improve on that and do better.
Liverpool lost 3-goal leads to draw 3-3 against Sevilla. Fan Sport will be back. Welcome back. Tunde, Sevilla 3, Liverpool 3. For me, I wish I could lie down the whole Liverpool team and give them 6 strokes each.
I think they deserve worse treatment. You can't imagine a team having a 3-goal lead in a game of that magnitude and bring it off. But you see, it's not the first time Liverpool are doing that this season. For everything they do right up front,
they do wrong at the end.
Luckily for them, they are still topping their group with 1 point. But if they had won that game, By now, their qualification for the round of 16 will have been sealed, signed, and delivered. But it's not good for the team. When you put so much, like we say here, starting only one, finishing, they will start very hard and finally they have to
initial ganga.
Good goals. Look at Firmino, look at Mane, the goals they scored. But at the end, they have to settle for a 1-1 draw.
Let us hope. 3-3 draw.
Sorry, 3-3 draw.
All right, thank you very much. That will be the show today. Until next time, have fun.